cream falling off the door hanging off the hinges.
Hey, my name is Chris, and I was born on December 5th, 1994, in the city of Bellflower, in Kaiser Hospital. I was born to a young Christian Ramirez at the time, and was raised mostly by my grandparents, my great-grandmother, and my mom. Without them, I would be nowhere near where I am today. I'm so thankful that they put up with me, whether I was happy, whether I was cranky, whatever it was. They dealt with Chris for 18 years. And now, here I am, going on to the next step in life.
You fucking did it. You really did it, yeah. You really did it. You really did it. You really did it.
Oh.
You really did it, yeah. You really did it. You really did it. All those who hanging around the water cooler will never believe how you tackled a thousand puzzle pieces. And you could see it before we completed it, before we made it whole. How you put it all together with the blindfold. You're like a lone game token that keeps the game going, but you claim to fame as how you like.
So you're probably wondering, what's Chris all about? What does he like to do? Well, I'm here to tell you that I like to help people. That's what I like to do. That's why I made Build On. Build On's an international organization that raises money so that way they can go build schools around the world. I mean, who wouldn't want to be part of that? Not only do you get to help your local community, but you get to help people on a larger scale. I wanted to make sure that other kids got the same opportunities we did here in America, because a lot of times we take it for granted, and I didn't want to be one of those people that did. Honestly, Build On has made a lasting experience and has taught me a bunch of lessons that I will never forget thanks to that trip to Nicaragua. That's why I Build On. There's no way I can pay you
back, but the plan is to show you that I understand. The woman right here is quite possibly the most important woman in my life. I love her. She's my foundation. She's my mom. She's my everything. My great-grandma and my grandparents were the greatest source that I could have for a roof. They taught me right from wrong and always made sure I was on the right path. I love them. No love for my daddy because the coward wasn't there.
He passed away and I didn't cry. What's my favorite moment in high school? My favorite English moment, to be specific. That's clearly my IOP. That was the most fun for me. I mean, not only did I get to talk about a music video, but I got to talk about a movie and a book all at the same time. They all related to each other. Of course, I could tell you to not procrastinate, but you're not really going to listen to that. I mean, I didn't listen to that. Why do you think I'm up doing this? But honestly, if you're going to procrastinate, do it well. Don't think that you're just going to slip on by with the procrastination nation attitude. You got to be able to really back up what you're doing. Read the books in class. Don't try to do it at home. You're going to want to do it at school, because honestly, you have so much time. You have SSR, you have break, you have lunch sometimes if you have nothing else to do. Honestly, the books are your best resource to any class. Use them wisely. Great Oak has prepared me for personal success by allowing me to really become a more people person. Not that I wasn't a people person before, but I mean, I've had a lot of ease with the IB program and making friends just because I have classes with all the same people. Also, the IB program's rigor has prepared me for my first year in college, hopefully. 5 years, I will hopefully have a really nice job coming out of college, coming from an internship for biomedical engineering. Seeing where that goes, maybe I'll go get an MBA, who knows? Honestly, I just want to get my bachelor's first. in 10 years, I hope to have gotten an MBA and be in some company where I'm selling or I'm marketing biomedical devices.